ದಿನ ಅನುಕ್ಷಣ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಕಲಿಕೆಯ ಹೊಸ ಹಾದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಯ ಹಾಕೋಣ ಸಂತಸದಿ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ
ಯಸ್
ಯಸ್ ಟೀಚರ್ ಸಸೆನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
Hello children, I heartily welcome to you all for this English class of 8th standard third language. Hope you are ready with your belongings. Today there is an activity. It is related to ourselves. The name of the activity is like, dislike. Yeah, like when we see the things which we love suddenly, unknowingly, what? A smile comes on our face, isn't it? Dislike, when we don't like the things, suddenly what happens? A frown face will come, isn't it, children? Yeah, the name of this activity is likes and dislike. Okay. Now I am going to share my likes and dislikes. Later you have to list, you have to draw the picture of like also and you have to draw the picture of dislike also. While you are listing your likes and dislikes. Yeah, shall I share my likes? Are you curious to see what Sahara ma'am likes? Okay, children. Yeah, my likes are, I like eating chocolates. Yeah, for me chocolates means very fond of. I like eating chocolates. I like playing. Yeah, I like to play even at school, even at home, even at friends also. I like to play. Playing means very energetic for me. It's a more passion for me, playing. Okay, then I like reading the books. Some books I like. So, I have mentioned I like reading the books. Okay. Next, I like what? Long walk in the morning. Yeah, as we wake up early in the morning, after morning prayer, I like to go for a long walk in the morning. These are all my likes. I like eating chocolates. I like playing. I like reading the books. I like long walk in the morning. The third one, reading the books, is there? No. These days it has become my like. Okay, children? See, you can see how my face is smiling, isn't it? Look at the logo also. When the things which we like, when we are expressing those things, the smile, big smile will come unknowingly. Okay. Dislike. See here. I don't like cats. Really, I don't know why. I don't like cats because it's small face. Somewhat I feel irritated. Yeah. I don't like taking tests. Yeah, I don't like taking tests. I don't like noise. Whenever I heard a noise, no? Irritation starts me. So, I don't like noise. I don't like reading books. Earlier, now also, 50-50 I am with the reading books. Sometimes I like and sometimes I don't like reading books. Okay, children? So, these are the likes and dislikes of mine. Now, it's your turn. What you have to do, miss? you have to write your likes and dislikes with your logos, and you have to share with your friends and family members. I hope you enjoyed this activity. You can ask your parents also. You can make a list of your mother's likes and dislikes. You can make a list of your father's likes and dislikes. Likewise, you can do this activity with your parents also. Then we will come to know our loved ones, what do they like and what they don't. Okay, children, let us move to the lesson. That is Shravana Kumara. Lesson 4, Shravana Kumara. Yeah, before going to the today's text, let us recall the points of earlier session. Children, see, in pink color you can see, Dasharatha ruled Ayodhya. During the time of Shravana Kumara, who was the king of Ayodhya? Dasharatha. Okay, then Shravana Kumara's parents were poor and blind. We saw in the last class, isn't it? Shravana Kumara's parents were poor and blind. Parents wanted to go on pilgrimage. One day, Shravana Kumara's parents told him, "Dear son, we want to go on pilgrimage to many holy places." Then, did Shravana Kumara say no to their parents? Did he refuse? No, na? Then, as usual, with the help of kavadi. Kavadi means? Yes, a sling used to carry with both ends. Isn't it? Yeah. Then he used to carry his parents with kavadi wherever they wished to go. While going on a journey, they saw a pleasant place, very peaceful place. Sundaravada, bhavyavada ondu sthalavannu avaru nortare. So, Shravana Kumara's parents wanted to rest there. Then, they told, "We want to rest here." So, Shravana built a small hut for their parent. Isn't it? He built small hut for his parents. Later, one day he noticed there was no water in a pot. Isn't it, children? So, he took the pot to fetch a water from the river. Fetch means going and coming back, isn't it? He took the pot and went to river to fetch the water. Okay, till there we discussed. Let us move on to the next text. Okay, children, see here. I will read out text for you. Pay your attention and listen carefully. Just at the time, King Dasharatha arrived at the other side of the river. He was such an expert in archery that he could hit the animals in any direction by merely listening to the sound caused by the movements. When he heard the sound of water filling the pot, he mistook it for the sound of an animal drinking water. He took his arrow and aimed in the direction of the sound and shot it. His aim was very accurate, and the arrow struck Shravana Kumara's right in the chest. The poor boar fell back with a cry of pain. Dasharatha was shocked when he heard the cry. He realized that he made a mistake and that a human being had been hurt. He rushed to other side of the river and found a wounded boy crying in a pain. Even in a such a painful condition, Shravana Kumara was only worried about his thirsty parents. Dasharatha came near the boy and begged for Shravana's forgiveness. Then Shravana cried out, "O king, I do not mind dying, but who will look after my blind old parents? I came here to fetch water for them. Please carry this water to them and satisfy their thirst." With these words, Shravana died. Okay, children, now it's your turn. Yeah, I will read it out. Look at the screen and repeat after me. Are you ready, children? Fine. Just at that time, King Dasharatha arrived at the other side of the river. He was such an expert in archery that he could hit the animals in any direction by merely listening to the sound caused by the moments when he heard the sound of water filling the pot. He mistook it for the sound of an animal drinking water. He took his arrow and aimed in the direction of the sound and shot it. His aim was very accurate and the arrow struck Shravana Kumar straight in the chest. The poor boy fell back with a cry of pain. Dasharatha was shocked when he heard the cry. He realized that he had made a mistake and that a human being had been hurt. He rushed to the other side of the river and found a wounded boy crying in a pain. Even in such a painful condition, Shravana was only worried about his thirsty parents. Dasharatha came near the boy and begged for Shravana's forgiveness. Shravana cried out, "O king, I do not mind dying, but who will look after my blind old parents? I came here to fetch water for them. Please carry this water to them and satisfy their thirst." With these words, Shravana died. Yes, children. Now, let us try to understand the text. Yeah. Shravana, in the darkness only, he went to the river to bring water. As he was filling the water, meanwhile, Ade Samayadalli, King Dasharatha had come for the forest. We all know King Dasharatha was expert in archery. Bilvidyalli tumba expert agidru. Haudalva? Then, as he was what? Filling the pot. Who? Shravana. Shravana, in what he was doing? He was filling the pot with water. At that time, neerina one shabda, the sound he heard. Who? Dasharatha. King Dasharatha heard the sound of, yeah, moment of water. What he thought, or yen ankon bitro? Yeah, an animal has come to drink the water. Already it was dark. See, in the darkness, we are unable to see what is happening on other side. In such darkness, Shravana Kumara was filling the pot and listening to that sound. What King Dasharatha do? As he was expert in archery, he took his arrow. Innodi, he took his arrow and aimed it in the direction of the sound. Yav kade shabda kelistittala, akade what he did? He, yes, aimed his arrow. Then what happened? Anyhow, he was expert. The archery, yeah, the arrow struck in the chest of Shravana Kumara. Look at the picture. Then King Dasharatha heard the sound of a cry. Oh, nanen madibitte, he thought. And he went to other side of the river. There he saw the arrow was struck in the chest of Shravana Kumara. He has mistaken. What he mistaken? He mistaken that the sound might be made by animal, but actually there was a human being who was filling the water in a pot for his thirsty parents. Isn't it, children? Then what happened? See, look at the picture. How the arrow has struck. See, so bad, na? And sometimes unknowingly how the things happen. See, yeah. Then Dasharatha came there. He came there and he felt very bad. He asked for the forgiveness. Nanang shamisi bidu, please manje maaf kardalo. Nanang shamisu. He asked. Even in that pain also, see, blood is coming. ರಕ್ತ ಹರಿತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಪೇನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಾಟ್ ಶ್ರವಣ ಕುಮಾರ ವಾಸ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್, ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ವರೀಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಅವ್ರ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿ ಯಾವ ಒಂದು ಬಾಯಾರಿಕೆ ಬಗ್ಗೆನೇ ಆಲೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಯಾರು? ಶ್ರವಣ ಕುಮಾರ. ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಪೇನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ ದಶರಥ ಟು ಪ್ಲೀಸ್, ಕುಡ್ ಯು ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಟು ಮೈ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಬ್ಲೈಂಡ್. ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಬಾಯಾರಿಕೆ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಈ ನೀರನ್ನ ತಗೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಾ ಅಂತ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡ. ಅಟ್ ದಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿ ಟುಕ್ ದ ಪಾಟ್, ದಶರಥ ಟುಕ್ ಪಾಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಶ್ರವಣ ಕುಮಾರ. ಆಸ್ ಸೂನ್ ಹಿ ಟುಕ್ ದ ಪಾಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಶ್ರವಣ ಕುಮಾರ ಡೈಡ್. ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸೀ ಇನ್ ಅ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಸನ್. ನೌ ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ಚೆಕ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ರಿಹೆನ್ಷನ್, ಹೌ ವೆಲ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಹೂ ವರ್ ಥರ್ಸ್ಟಿ, ಹೂ ವರ್ ಥರ್ಸ್ಟಿ, ಗಡ್. ಶ್ರವಣಾಸ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಥರ್ಸ್ಟಿ. ವೈ ಡಿಡ್ ಶ್ರವಣ ಗೋ ಟು ದ ರಿವರ್? ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್, ಶ್ರವಣ ವೆಂಟ್ ಟು ದ ರಿವರ್ ಟು ಬ್ರಿಂಕ್ ವಾಟರ್. ವಾಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ ಟು ದ ಶ್ರವಣಾಸ್ ಚೆಸ್ಟ್? ಯಾ, ದ ಆರೋ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ ಟು ದ ಶ್ರವಣಾಸ್ ಚೆಸ್ಟ್. Then children, what happened to Dasharatha when he heard the cry? Shabda keli takshna yen agute Dasharatha rajanige? Yes, you are right. Dasharatha was shocked when he heard the cry. He was shocked when he heard the cry of a human being. Now it's time for proper noun. Grammar time. Today let us learn about proper noun, children. A noun that names a particular person, place, animal, thing is called a proper noun. Yes, highlight, focus on the words which are in blue color: person, place, animal, thing. In last class also we have come across these words: person, place, animal, thing. There, generic, general agi. How delva? Here, in common noun, it is generic. But in proper noun, particular. Avare, anta helti valla. Yeah, you will come to know with the examples. A noun that names a particular, yes children, yes, person, place, animal, thing is called proper noun. Proper noun always begins with the capital letter. Remind that proper noun always begin with the capital letter. Okay, let us see the example. People: Arman, Hima, Priya. Pets: Lucy, Rosie, Puppy. Days: Sunday, Monday, Friday. Rivers: Ganga, Tunga, Kaveri. See, observe all those words here. See, look here. Observe all these words. Always proper noun begins with capital letter. Fine, children? Okay, let us see few more examples. Look here. Festivals: Ramazan, Diwali, Christmas. Languages: Kannada, Hindi, English. Yeah, we should. These are all particular noun, so we call them as proper nouns. Yes, Kannada, Hindi, English. Country: Sri Lanka, Germany, India. monuments, Red Fort, Gol Gumbaz, Taj Mahal. Okay, children. All these particulars. Adhe vandu ooru anta heltivalla. Bengaluru, Koppala, Kolara, Bijapura, all we say, no, Hubli. Those are particular towns, isn't it? Cities. Okay. Those particulars are said to be a proper noun. I think you got a clear idea about common noun and proper noun. Now let us move to the activity. What you are supposed to do means, here more few words have been given. You had to identify and circle the proper nouns in the table given below. I will read it out. First, I will read it out vertically. Sunday, May, umbrella. Ganga, tiger, Himalayas. Football, Radha, Diwali. Bengaluru, Hindi, pen. Kite, Ambedkar, girl. These are all proper nouns. Finished? So soon. Very nice. Let us see them. Yes, children. Whatever you have circled. Sunday, May. Ganga, Himalayas. Radha, Diwali. Bengaluru, Hindi. Ambedkar. Yes, children. Whatever the words have been circled, they are all proper nouns. Yeah, the other words, they are common nouns. Fine, children. One more activity for you. Read the following sentences and identify the proper nouns in them. Agle shuru madibitra nivo. See there? I will read out the sentences for you. I will read the sentences. Focus, common noun also is there. Proper noun also is there. Focus on proper noun. Okay, children, you have to, yes, identify the proper nouns. I will read out the sentence for you. Varsha was reading a book. My favorite festival is Holi. The name of my pet parrot is Sweetie. Sunday is holiday. My favorite story is Aladdin. And the sixth one is uncle speaks Kannada. Okay, children? Yeah. Do you want me to read once more? Varsha was reading a book. My favorite festival is Holi. Third one. The name of my pet parrot is Sweetie. Sunday is holiday. My favorite story is Aladdin. Uncle speaks Kannada. I think you all have identified the proper nouns. Let us look into them. Varsha, very nice. In second sentence, Holi, very good. In third sentence, Sweetie, superb. Sunday, very nice, children. Aladdin and Kannada. Varsha, Holi, Sweetie, Sunday, Aladdin, Kannada. These are proper nouns. Now it's time for assignment. Write the common nouns and proper nouns from your surroundings. Nimma sutta mutta. What you have to write? Common nouns list madbeku, proper nouns list madbeku, and share it with your friends and parents. Okay, children, this is your assignment. Along with that, you have to read the textbook also. Fine, children. I hope you enjoyed today's session too. Okay, children. This is B.B. Sahira, assistant teacher, GHPS Lachankeri, Koppal Taluk and district. Now, it's time to say bye for you. Take care. Let us meet in a next class. Bye, children.
Anudina, anukshana, maniyellu kaliyona.
ಐಕೆಯ ಹೊಸ ಹಾದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಯ ಹಾಕೋಣ ಸಂತಸದಿ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ
ಎಸ್ ಟೀಚರ್ ದ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.